So in this video, I will show you how to organize our PyTorch code with Lightning. Just like PyTorch, Lightning is a free and open source library. You can think of the features in Lightning that we are using as an extension that helps you organize your PyTorch code and that provides you with extra functionality. So here are a few of the things that the Lightning module and the Lightning trainer makes more convenient for us. So we have multi-GPU training, training a model on multiple GPUs. We have checkpointing of models, logging, evaluation, and there are also little convenience features like automatic learning rate finders and batch size finders. Of course, it also helps us organize our code, and there are features like mixed precision training that can help accelerate our training, as we will see in later units. And of course, it also allows us to export our models so that we can use them later in different contexts for production. So as I mentioned earlier, the two components we are going to take a look at are the Lightning module and the Lightning trainer. So here what you see is a simple outline of a regular PyTorch model, such as the models that we implemented in Unit 4. And here is an outline of how a Lightning module looks like. So there are several methods here: a training step, a validation step, and a test step. So don't worry too much about these individual methods yet. We will have hands-on coding examples where we will show you how to use these methods in detail. However, the takeaway here is that the Lightning module is really just a wrapper around the PyTorch model. So in fact, we usually define our Lightning module such that it receives a PyTorch model as its input. And then it provides us with organized methods, for example, the training step, the validation step, and the test step for model usage. Yeah, and the Lightning trainer really makes the model training much more convenient. So instead of implementing our own training loop in PyTorch, we use this Lightning Trainer class. So in this Lightning Trainer class, we can set a lot of different options. For example, the number of epochs, which accelerator we want to use, a CPU or a GPU. And we can also define a logger for logging our data, as we will see later. And there are many, many more advanced functionalities, as we will also discover later. So if you are curious, we will share more resources with you about all the different options that are available, but we will also cover a lot of these options in this class. And then we can train the Lightning model, which wraps the PyTorch model, using trainer.fit. But if this looks a little bit intimidating and complicated at first, we will actually have a dedicated coding example and videos to show you how this works exactly. So now that we outlined the two main components that we will be using, the Lightning trainer and the Lightning module, how do we actually install Lightning? So personally, I just recommend using pip install Lightning. So at this point, I also wanted to mention that the Lightning library was formerly called PyTorch Lightning. However, since Lightning has grown and there is a lot of advanced functionality in there, it's not just for PyTorch anymore. And it's now also just called Lightning. All right, so in this video, we introduced the two core API components, Lightning module and Lightning trainer, that we will be using for training our PyTorch models. So in the next video, we will see how we can train the multi-layer perceptron from Unit 4 that we implemented in PyTorch using Lightning.